I started being interested in collecting when I was 7, 8 years old. Those days in school, the students used to run around and sell each other stamps. So I found it interesting. So I started to buy a few, and then I had a few of my own. And bit by bit, I realized that by doing that, I'm doing something that gives me a lot of pleasure. I didn't think of making money or thinking of financial part of it at all. It was just a bug. So that's how it started. I went to a school in Iran, and when I graduated, I decided that I want to leave and go to the United States. So I went to the United States in 1967. And by 1970, I was already very active in buying art in different fields. So our collecting activities goes back to about 5 decades. I was thinking about it in actual fact last night, telling myself we have almost 35,000 objects, 8 different collections. By the time we finish our publication, it's over 100 volumes, out of which probably 75 are out within the next 6 months. And we always call ourselves collector. But then I said, no, it is a bit more than just collector. So we are collector of collections. That's how it should be reframed. Because in 8 areas, we not only collect them, we conserve them, research them, publish them, and exhibit them around the world. By collecting art, by exhibiting them, by publishing them, is a form of cultural philanthropy. Because what we are doing, we are bringing virtually 8 sleeping giants to the attention of the world, something that people were not aware of. And we are really proud that we found Wikipedia as a platform, as a partner. So we are giving you something that you probably were looking for. And we are very lucky to find a place that could promote what we always wanted to do. Collecting is not something which is for individuals. If you are a collector, you have a huge responsibility. If you don't share your love of collecting and what you collect with the masses, then don't call yourself a collector. You're a selector for your own pleasure. So we are hoping that this partnership that we have with you would bring this treasure trove of objects and all the things that we have done, including the research and publication, to the public to enjoy. But I still believe that if you have certain information that can benefit others, share it with them. Don't be selfish with your information. Nowadays, people are becoming self-centered. The I is becoming very common to use, and the we's are disappearing. And if we start saying we rather than I, we would have a much better world to live in. And that's the problem we have today in our society. So what we do is we say, we are sharing it with you. We are bringing the information to your room. And this is what you do through the Wikipedia. This is what you do. Everything that we have done for the last 50 years, virtually, you're starting to seep it in, into their homes, into their screens. So they look at the picture and they say, you know, I like this. Where can I find similar thing? So then they start thinking, which museum should I go to? So one thing would lead to another. And it would enrich their lives. And this is what we want to do. I always say that religion and politics have their own languages, but the language of art is universal. I stick to the universality of language of art.